Well, Omar, what's your reaction to that one this evening?
Yeah, I really liked our first period and the first 10 minutes we came out like we usually come out. And, you know, maybe more we came out like we did against Sheffield on Saturday night. We had a lot of energy, a lot of jump. We created a lot of chances, and Basco made some big saves at the start. And then, yeah, we conceded that first goal, and it just seemed that the wave shifted dramatically. And, you know, they scored that second early in the second, and we just didn't click much offensively. And that was the biggest obstacle we had all night. And but I don't think it was a 6-0 game. I just think we didn't have that that edge and those chances that we would have liked.
Yeah, I mean, the effort certainly has been there from the players all week in terms of trying to really do something. As I suppose there's a disappointed dressing room right now.
Yeah, I think they're all disappointed. But, you know, you face a team like that, that, you know, it's just like when they went on, they went on. And it wasn't one game that they had the puck the whole game we were defending. It was more like a team like that. They were opportunistic and they were clinical. And, you know, they didn't mean as many chances as us to create, you know, goals. There's a reason why they're the champions. There's a reason why they're Challenge Cup champions as well, and you know, potentially they'll win it tomorrow as well. So yeah, it's a tough night, but I'm proud of the group overall for where they came and what we accomplished. It was it's just a bit disappointing tonight that we couldn't get our groove going, and but that's sometimes the other teams when they play that well, and I thought Belfast played like true champions.
I suppose you can look at the season as an underdog story in many respects, especially last weekend when you knocked out Sheffield Steelers, which most people weren't seeing as a possibility. I know it's too early to ask you to reflect on the whole season overall, but has it been an underdog story to an extent?
I think we got one more game tomorrow, and I do think we need to find our game a bit tomorrow too, just to finish off the season really well with the group, because they're a good bunch of guys, and they loved every minute of their time in Dundee. Yeah, I mean, looking back, I thought what Kiefer said in press conference was too. I really thought from the start of the year, I know we went down and we lost guys and we had losing streaks, but I always felt confident we should be in the Final Four, and we accomplished that. But tonight's a bit disappointing, but it's not necessarily disappointing for the guy. It's more, you know, it just didn't click tonight, and that's the, you know, of all the games that didn't click in the last 2-3 months, this is probably the game that didn't click the most. But again, sometimes you got to give credit to the other team. And anytime we had a sniff or an opportunity, you know, you had the best goalie in the league, just make it look easy. So I think it was a tough night.
I know you said in the press conference that the third, fourth playoff game tomorrow is the bronze medal game. Many fans have witnessed these games previously with different, I suppose, expectations. What's your expectations for the players tomorrow on this one?
Just to finish the season hard as a group. You know, like any year, you have some guys retiring, you have some guys moving to, you know, other places. You got some guys that will come back to Dundee, but it's the last time they'll be together as a group. So listen, it's up to them, man. It's up to us, and it's up to the whole club to push them on to have a competitive third and fourth game. But I think there's enough in that dressing room where there's a lot of fans here, and they want to be thankful for them, and they want to offer the performance they can. And you know what? It's almost like the last 3 months has been such a battle, highs, lows, and obviously more highs. But tonight is one that if we can manage a good game tomorrow, I think we can leave here our head high.
Talking ahead high and leaving head high, the fans have been terrific this season, this week. I know when you first came into the club in 2017, your ambition was to fill the Dundee Ice Arena. It was to have the section sold out at the playoffs here like it was today. I mean, how special was that for you to see those fans this week and everything they've done and what they, I suppose, mean to the players this year as well?
It's a special moment, and we're really appreciative of everything they've done. And I don't know, you can ask the players, because I always say it, but the players probably see they'll clap them on outside. They'll be a part of it. But the buzz we've had since this team in the last, you know, since post-pandemic and all the downs and, you know, all the shows we used to do, and just to keep people engaged. And the last month, this past week has been incredible, and you know, wish wish we could have just enjoyed it even more, you know what I mean, and take a time and take almost a step back and enjoy it. But we really wanted to do something special here, and it didn't work out tonight, but tomorrow is an opportunity.
Well, Omar, thank you very much.
Thank you.